It's time now for the Peter Chill 11 a.m. news report for this Wednesday morning, April 15th, 2015. Good morning and afternoon, everybody. I'm Peter Wiggins, 11 a.m. news headlines here. And our top story at 11 a.m. is in Fall River, Massachusetts, where a Massachusetts jury of 7 women and 5 men found Aaron Hernandez, a former New England Patriot tight end, guilty of first-degree murder of Odin Lloyd in 2013 to conclude a 9-week trial in the Bristol County Superior Court. In Tehran, Iran, Iranian President Hassan Rouhani on Wednesday dismissed pressure from the U.S. Congress over a preliminary deal on Iran's nuclear program, saying that Tehran is dealing with a world power, not American lawmakers. North Carolina will be an early test for Hillary Clinton. U.S. stocks are higher Wednesday as investors took to the 2 p.m. release of the Fed's latest page book report on the economy, and market watchers were still buzzing about a stunning protest at an ECB press conference. As we take a look at the stock market report here, Dow 18,136.90, up 100.20, S&P 500.2108.13, up 12.29, and Nasdaq 5,002.43, up 25.14. SpaceX continues to get closer to achieving its founder Elon Musk's dream of being able to recycle rockets. Video released by the private space company shows the Falcon 9 rocket hitting its target when it returned to Earth on Tuesday. In Geneva, International White Sea Agency said 2015 is shaping up to be the deadliest year for migrants crossing the Mediterranean Sea. West of Baghdad, Iraq. Finally, Asari shouted on the phone as he described the situation as from the point of view. ISIS militants might be just hours away from taking the key city of Ramadi, Iraq. Chicago chef Habal Kantu, whose scientific approach to food made him a star in the city's dining scene, has died at the age of 38, what police say appears to be a suicide. Palestinian fighters have events in clashes with Islamic State militants in the Yemen refugee camp at Damascus, Palestinian officials said. The Fed said judge misconstrued on Obama on immigration. Al-Qaeda is beating the Islamic State. GOP insiders applaud Clinton rollout. The hidden battle to battle the Air Force's new stealth bomber and Clinton names top three workers for the campaign. In Boston, the second anniversary of the Boston Marathon bombings brought together survivors and rescuers Wednesday as the city prepared to mark the day with a moment of silence that tolled in church bells and a call for contests. In Centennial, Colorado, a union plumber, a school teacher, and a survivor of the 1999 Columbine High School massacre were among 19 women and 5 men chosen as jurors in the death penalty trial of Aurora Theater shooter James Holmes. Finally, Congress will case bill reshaping Medicare doctors' fees. Dashcam video shows Arizona cop running over armed suspect with a patrol car. The events were organized by the union-backed Fight for $15 campaign, which is demanding that McDonald's Corporation of a fast food chain raise the minimum wages to $15, let workers unionize. Coming as among U.S. home builders rose in April for the first time in 5 months as prospective buyers returned to the market and sales climbed. It's an improvement over the last year, but not enough of a rebound for Wall Street as Bank of America has reported first quarter earnings results Wednesday morning, and while the bank profited compared February to $26 million net loss reported 1 year ago. Nokia OG agreed to buy Alcatel, Lucent, SA, and an all-stock deal valued at $15.6 billion, which is $16.6 billion in American money to create the world's largest supply of equipment that powers mobile phone networks. A team of astronomers studied the simultaneous collision of 4 galaxies in a galaxy cluster, ABEL-3827, and could trace out where the mass lies within the system and compare the distribution of the dark matter with the positions of luminous galaxies. Just how realistic is that to be believed that humans will someday find evidence of extraterrestrial life, as NASA's chief scientist previously predicted that we'd find signs of life beyond Earth within a decade or so, but a new study by researchers at Penn State certainly will clues about whether men's children may increase risk of autism, a small study suggests. Tweaking in the brain's immune system with a drug that has prevented mice developing dementia, a study shows that the team at Duke University, the U.S., showed immune cells which start attacking nutrients in the brain may be triggered disease. And take a look at sports news here. Duke freshman guard Tyus Jones, the most outstanding player during the Final Four, will enter the NBA draft, Coach Mike Krzyzewski said on Wednesday. It has been more than a century since the Cleveland Indians started their home schedule with 5 straight losses that they would much rather not make history on Wednesday. And this afternoon, the Boston Red Sox will be at Fenway Park taking on the Washington Nationals. Game time, 1:35 p.m. And the Boston Celtics will be wrapping up their regular season in Milwaukee against the Milwaukee Bucks. Game time, 8 o'clock. Peter Chell News, I'm Zale, 11:05. And it's time now for a travel report here. And Southeast freshman and northbound side slow from Fredericksburg Parkway all the way up to Mass Ave in Boston due to an accident in the Southeast Expressway and the southbound side around Dorchester, so expect some delays. Here, 129 on the northbound side, slow from Route 1 in Norwood all the way down Route 109 Westwood, so expect a few delays. Here, Mass back in the eastbound side, slow from the Austin Brighton Tolls all the way up to the Prue Tunnel. Here, 93 on the northbound side, slow from 133 in the Nandover, Danford, 495. 495 in the northbound side, slow from Westford, Danford, Route 4 in Chelmsford. Here, Everett Turnpike in the Manchester Amateurs. A little slow down for Manchester Amateur stretch due to some road work on the Everett Turnpike. Here, Route 16 on the northbound side and the Spalding Turnpike. A little slow after Route 4 in Durham. Here, but otherwise, a smooth sailing commute here. And on Cape Downs, Route 6 in the eastbound side, slow from East Sandwich down for Route 149 and West Brunswick. Route 6 westbound, slow from Sandwich down for the Sagamore Bridge on the westbound side of Route 6 here. And Newport Bridges on the eastbound side, a little slow. Jamestown Bridge on the westbound side, slow in Rhode Island there. And the on-ramp to 495 from the Mass back to a little slow in Westbury, but I expect a few delays, but otherwise a smooth sailing commute here. And Route 3 in the northbound side, a little slow after you get on Route 3 from Route 6 in Sagamore here. And on the MBTA, Civil Line SL5 experiencing minor delays due to traffic here. And on a commuter rail, Fitchburg, South Acton Line, train 454, 9:51 a.m. from Littleton, 485. Late today, 10 to 20 minutes due to signal problem here. And Providence, Stoughton Line, train 8:14, 9:10 a.m. from Whitford Junction delay today, 15, 20 minutes due to Amtrak Intercity train conflict here. And Permanent Stoughton Line, train 8:05, 9:55 a.m. from substation delay today, 10, 15 minutes due to a trespasser problem here. Peter Chell News, I'm 11:07, 10 and a half for a travel time of a weather report, and we are under a wet flag warning from now until 7 p.m. this evening. For all Massachusetts except Nantucket, for elevated fire weather potential, relative humidity is at or below 30% and wind gusts of 25 miles per hour. As the affected area for the red fog warning includes all of Massachusetts except Nantucket, winds of 10 to 15 miles per hour, gusts around 25 miles per hour, and time in mid-morning for early evening, and relative humidity as low as 15%, and temperature reaching highs around the mid to upper 60s, and impacts dry weather and gusty winds will result in critical fire weather conditions here. And a wet fog warning means that critical fire weather conditions are either occurring now or will surely any fires that start may spread rapidly and become difficult to extinguish here. And day 2 of 7, Thursday to Tuesday. And on Thursday, a lack of weather. Thursday, a lack of rain combined with dry conditions yields and an elevated fire weather potential. Red fog warnings or fire weather statements may have to be issued here. Alright, take a look at a 7-day forecast of goals like this here. For today, sunny skies about 6 more degrees. Dark face with about 9 miles per hour. For tonight, clear sky low about 29 degrees. Dark with about 6 miles per hour. For Thursday, sunny skies about 60 degrees. Light and variable wave cover at 7 at 5 to 7 miles by the afternoon. Thursday, night, a slight chance of showers after 2 a.m. Podcast sky low about 38 degrees. At 7 with about 6 miles per hour. Chance of precipitation is 20%. Friday, slight chance of showers. Most skies have about 6 degrees at southwest Vermont, 6 to 8 miles per chance of precipitation is 40%. France, slight chance of showers before 2 a.m. Most skies got low about 47 degrees at chance of precipitation is 20%. For Saturday, chance of showers after 4 p.m. Parks and Podcast got about 69 low about 43 degrees. Chance of precipitation is 30%. For Sunday, Saturday Podcast got about 60 low about 38 degrees. For Monday, chance of rain, most skies got about 55 low about 41 degrees. Chance of precipitation is 30%. Up and into 50% by Monday night, and for Tuesday, chance of rain, mostly cloudy skies, high about 58 degrees, and chance of precipitation is 50%. Norton temperature, 65 degrees in first sky. That is coming in for the Peter Channel. 11 a.m. news report on this. Wednesday morning, Wednesday afternoon, April 15th, 2015. Peter, you have a good day, and we'll see you later on. Bye-bye, everybody, with a good positive attitude here.